Ozone. It's good up high, but bad nearby. The ozone that naturally forms in the Earth's upper atmosphere and protects us from the sun's harmful UV rays is the same chemical compound that forms at ground level, where we live, work, and play. However, unlike in the upper atmosphere, ground-level ozone can have an adverse impact on health. When inhaled, it can irritate the lining of the respiratory tract, including the nose, throat, and lungs. Plants can feel the impacts of ground-level ozone pollution too. Trees and other plants, including crops like corn and soybeans, can begin to show signs of distress after high levels of ozone are present for a few days. Ground-level ozone is not directly emitted from smokestacks or tailpipes, but forms via chemical reactions in the atmosphere between other pollutants like volatile organic compounds and oxides of nitrogen. These ozone precursors are mainly emitted from sources that burn fossil fuels like coal, gas, or diesel. The ozone precursors that affect Wisconsin's air quality may originate in other states, particularly those to the south. The highest measured ozone concentrations typically occur downwind of urban areas on hot, sunny days with light winds. Therefore, the department monitors for ozone from spring through fall. The DNR Air Program monitors for ozone at 30 monitoring stations throughout the state and shares the information with the public in near real time. Wisconsin counties along Lake Michigan experience the highest ozone concentrations on days with southerly winds, which transport ozone precursors north into Wisconsin. Ozone transport occurs when the winds blow precursors out over Lake Michigan, where they react in the presence of sunlight to form ozone. When the land has warmed sufficiently, temperature changes from the shoreline to the lake can create pressure differences, which cause an onshore flow of air, or lake breeze. Winds from the south, in combination with the lake breeze, push ozone formed over the lake onshore, causing ozone concentrations in Wisconsin to be closely correlated with the distance from the Lake Michigan shoreline. Winds from the south carry the ozone plume gradually northward along Wisconsin's coastline. While the state currently has portions of lakeshore counties in non-attainment of the ozone standard, the vast majority of Wisconsin's population lives in areas meeting all federal air quality standards. Overall, ozone pollution in the state has decreased over the last two decades, and emissions of ozone precursors in the state have decreased by 50% since 2002. Reducing ozone levels along the lakeshore requires a regional, multi-state approach. In addition to the ozone monitoring network, DNR has a state-of-the-art mobile air monitoring lab used to measure a suite of pollutants, including ozone precursors, along Wisconsin's lakeshore. Informed by DNR's air quality forecast, the mobile lab is deployed throughout the summer to capture ozone precursor measurements when elevated levels of ozone are predicted. Real-time ozone levels can be viewed at any monitor by visiting DNR's air quality map. We can all play a role in reducing ozone formation across Wisconsin. Vehicles continue to be the largest source of ozone-forming pollutants in Wisconsin. Consider taking the bus, carpooling, or biking to work or school. Other small tasks can continue to improve Wisconsin's air quality as well. Consider the use of electric lawn equipment instead of equipment with gas-powered motors. Conserve energy around the house by turning off lights and appliances when not in use. Wisconsin is committed to clean air. For more information, visit dnr.wi.gov and search air quality.